In this video, I want to talk about how a coach like myself looks at a training week versus often how an athlete looks at a training week. I think understanding the sort of the different viewpoint gives you an idea of how to optimize your training. It actually can reduce your stress when things don't go exactly as planned. So here's an example. This is a level 3 half marathon plan from a woman that I was working with last summer. So I've loaded it for this year so you can kind of see the plan. So she had a long run on Sunday, a day off on Monday, easy run Tuesday, an optional day, this recovery day always gives you the option. You can run if you normally run on that day and it gives you that option, or you can cross train, or you can just take the day completely off. It's sort of you listening to your body and adjusting. And then this big speed workout, this was an important workout for us. We wanted to get this in because she really wanted to work on her speed, felt like that was a component missing in her half marathon racing in the past. Another recovery day on Friday, easy run Saturday, and then the fast finish long run on Sunday. And as you probably know, if you've done a half marathon or marathon plan of mine, I really like these fast finish long runs. They are a critical component to being race ready for these longer races. The most kind of race specific workout you can do are these fast finish long runs. Well, of course, I was like, this is kind of the week and how we want to, the things we want to get in. But she viewed it as, I have to do everything exactly as stated or it is a failure. Well, of course, that's not a good viewpoint for the training. The training is built to be flexible. So, for example, and this happened from time to time, the speed workout scheduled for Thursday, which was really important to her, something came up and she wasn't able to get that in. So she felt very upset that she missed that workout. And I said, it's not a problem. The system can adapt based on your life schedules. So we have a couple of choices. We can slide it to the next day and sort of switch these days around. That's one option that we have. The only challenge there, as you might expect, is that now she only has one recovery day before this really important fast finish long run. So this I was not in favor of. I felt like that would compromise her preparedness for the fast finish long run. So we'll kind of move this back. And you have this power in your training plan. You can drag and drop workouts very easily, just as I'm doing on the screen here. The other option was, because she missed this workout, we could look in the schedule at other and see, is there anything we can maybe slot in? And down here, there was this fartlek run. Let me pull it into the frame here. There was a fartlek run, 8 to 10 times 1 minute. So why don't we put that there? That seemed like a good substitute. We could get in some VO2 max work, but it was obviously a lighter workout than 1200 meter repeats. And we know from the past, it wouldn't leave her so fatigued for the fast finish long run. So that was an option that I kind of liked. And we would just maybe move this workout to the future and see if we want to do the 1200s versus the 1600s that are scheduled for this day. And that seemed to be a good solution. She did the fartlek and then felt good on the fast finish long run. So I bring this up just to sort of illustrate the point that when I look at the training schedule and the training week, to me, it's the idea, but we have to be open to modifying it based on your life schedule and how you're feeling. So while certainly this was the idea that we were going to get this speed workout in on Thursday, but something came up and she missed it. That's just the way it goes. And you'll see me post this in the message boards a lot where I will say somebody will miss a key workout and there's no really good spot to fit it in. I'll say, hey, don't worry about it. Let's just skip it. We've got another speed workout coming up. Don't worry about it. They think, oh, am I not going to achieve my goal because I missed this workout? Of course not. One missed workout, one bad workout, one sort of negative situation does not make or break your full training cycle. So remember, when you look at these weeks, be open to moving things around. If we hadn't had prior notice that her Thursday was going to kind of get out of control, then we would have just slid this over. We would have moved the speed workout to Wednesday. She had plenty of recovery from her long run. we would have gotten it in on this day, and then she could take in that recovery day on the sort of crazy life schedule day that she had. So I bring this up just so that you realize you've got control, move things around, make adjustments that make sense, use common sense. But remember, it's a dance. This is the idea of the training, and this is what happens. That's part of the coaching process. That's part of the training process. When I work with athletes, I'm always saying, how are you feeling? Looking ahead, do we need to adjust something? Because to me, training is not just about the training schedule, it's about the adjustments to the training schedule. That's the key component to being your best on race day. So I hope this little video, just sort of showing how you can slide workouts around, look ahead to make sure you're not compromising recovery for another key workout, and making it fit a little bit more in your life schedule, takes the pressure off, allows you to see training as something that is fluid. We have the idea, we have the roadmap, but we often have to adjust based on life and how you feel. And ultimately, as you get more and more comfortable with making those adjustments, you'll see the quality of your training continue to go higher and higher, and you won't have as many sort of bad workouts because you're not prepared. And then also mentally, you'll feel better about your training because you're not so concerned or wrapped up in the fact that you miss a workout or you have to modify the training program. That's the way I set up the system, so that you could modify it to always be in an optimal situation for you and how you're feeling, as well as your life schedule. As always, if you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I'll talk to you again real soon.